Hello everyone, once again I would like to welcome all of you into the class of environmental studies. Friends, last 5 to 6 lectures we are going to see the first topic of our syllabus and the name of topic is environment. Now from today's lecture we are going to start second chapter and the name of chapter is energy resources. But before going to start the chapter we will remind some points or concepts in chapter first. In first chapter we will see the different points. Out of that, first one is meaning of environment. After that, the segments of environment, and next point like environmental issues, all the different types of issues we will going to see in detail, and later one that finally we will going to see the concept of 4R, and these all the concept are nothing but it is a chapter first. And later on that we are going to start from today's the chapter second, and the name of chapter is energy resources. This is very important topic in environment because the first chapter is environment and this is very basic chapter because you will already seen most of the concept in school level. So from the chapter we are going to start our syllabus. So from this lecture we are going to start today's concept. At first, meaning of energy resources or the introduction of our today's topic or introduction of our second chapter, energy resources. Once again I would like to welcome all of you in this lecture. Today we will going to start second and very important topic in our syllabus. The name of our topic is energy resource. This is a very important topic because most of the objective questions are asked on this topic in your semester examination. So today we will going to start the concept present in our syllabus. At first we will going to see the natural resources, and these resources are divided by different types. What are the different types of natural resources? So the natural resources will be divided into 6 different types. Out of that, first one is forest resource, second one is water resource, third one is mineral resource, fourth one is food resource, fifth one is energy resource, and last is land resources. So by using this chapter we will going to well understand the concept of energy resources. Means that from these 6 different sources we will going to form energy. So we will going to study detail all the points. At first, today we will going to start the first energy resource, which is categorized into the natural resource. And the first one is forest resource. So in this concept we will going to see the different points. At first, introduction of forest resource. Second, uses of forest resource. Third one is over exploitation. Fourth one is deforestation, its causes and its effects. Then timber extraction, these are the very important point. Then mining, and last point is dams and their effects on forest and tribal people. So these are the different points we are going to cover in these topics. So let us start the first point, that is introduction of forest resource. So the word forest is derived from a Latin word. You know that the Latin language. In this Latin language, one word is there, and the word is forest, means in English language outside area. So the forest means outside. Now the forest are one of the most important natural resources of the earth. Approximately 1/3 of the earth total area is covered by forest. Means that if we consider 100% area, then 25% area is covered by means of forests. So these are the very important information we will going to see in introductory part. Along with this introduction, we will going to see another important points regarding with forest resources. Forest resources play an important role in the economy of any country. It is highly complex. Changing environment made up of living as well as non-living things. So you know that the meaning of living things or non-living things. In 10th class, we will going to see the factors like living organism, non-living organism, biotic factors, abiotic factors. So these are the things related to these concepts. So living things included, let us see this example. Living things include trees, shrubs, wildlife, etc. And non-living things include water, nutrient, rocks, and sunlight and air. So these are the different types of examples given here. Forests vary a great deal in composition and density and are the distinct from meadows and pastures. Forests are important to humans and the natural world. We know that the different types of uses of forests. So it is very important to living and non-living organisms. So for humans, they have many aesthetic, recreational, economic, historical, cultural, and religious values. So that the forest resource is very important to us. Forests provide fuel, wood, timber, wildlife, habitat, industrial forest products, climate regulation, and medicinal. So these are the different types of uses of forests, and it is very useful to everyone. So that these resources are very important to us. Now we will going to see the area of forest will be covered on the surface of earth. If we see the Indian scenario, then we will going to understand how many area covered by forest resource on the surface of earth. In India, forest cover estimated to 21.02% of the country's geographical area. It means that out of, if we are going to consider 100% geographical area, then 21.02% area covered by forest. And the forest will be divided into different types, and all these types are going to cover 21.02%. The total forest covers in India, read this kilometer, 690,899 kilometer area will be covered by means of these types of resources. So these are the very important. Forest covers in India is defined as all the lands more than 1 hectare in area with a tree and density is more than 10. So these are the different types of areas covered by means of forest resource. Here the degree classification will be given: very dense forest, moderately dense forest, open forest, scrub area, and non-forest. So these are the estimated by means of, by using geographical information. If you look at the map of India, then we will going to understand the different types of forest. Here the shades of different color will be given, and if we look at very close, then we will going to observe all over India these resources will be present. Now we will going to see the detail about the different types of forest. So that the different types of forests, like first one is tropical white evergreen forest, and this will be present in Western Ghats, which will be covered by the different states like Maharashtra, Karnataka, and Kerala. Second type of forest is tropical semi-evergreen, and this will be present in the lower hills of Western Ghats. Third type is tropical moist deciduous, and this will be divided into the area of
Dehradun and Mahabaleshwar. Fourth one is Dam Forest will be present in Sundarban and Bengal Delta and Andaman. So these are the different types of forest and its divided or its covered the area of whole our country, India country. So these are the different types of forest present in India. After that, the second type of forest are present in dry tropical forest region. So these are further divided into three different types. First one is tropical dry deciduous, and it will be divided into the states like Madhya Pradesh and Uttar Pradesh. Second type is tropical thorn forest, and which it will be observed on the area of Delhi, Punjab and Gujarat. Third type is tropical dry evergreen. It will be present in Eastern Ghats like the states like Andhra Pradesh and Tamil Nadu. So on these topic or particular these concepts, we will going to ask, or the board will be going to ask objective questions. You will be given the dry tropical region areas, and we will going to find out where the tropical dry evergreen forest will be present, and in option we will going the different options like Maharashtra, Tamil Nadu, Punjab or Odisha. So the correct answer is Tamil Nadu. Last one is Montana subtropical forest. It will be again divided into different types. First one is coniferous forest, and it will be further divided into three different types: subtropical broad, and it will be present in Shillong and Nilgiris; subtropical pine forest, it will be present in Arunachal Pradesh and Kashmir; and third point is subtropical dry evergreen foothills of Himalayas. The another name of subtropical dry evergreen forest is called as dash. This type of objective are definitely asked in your semester exam. So the answer is foothills of Himalayas. So these type of questions are definitely asked. One or two questions will be definitely present on the types of forest. Now the next point is uses of forests. Generally we know that where the forest will be used. Let us see here. The functions of forest may broadly classified into different categories. First one is local consumptive use. Second one is productive or market use. Third one is ecosystem service. And fourth one is other uses. Now we will going to see the first one is local consumptive use. Food like roots, fruits, tubers, fish, mushrooms and animal meat. Fooders for cattle, fuel wood. The wood is used for the purpose of fuel like cooking, for the cooking and other purposes by poor people. Construction material like poles and thatching leaves. Fibers for weaving baskets, ropes, nets and mats. Medicinal plant for treating common diseases. We know that we will be going to use different Ayurvedas. So their treatment will be take place by means of these types of forest resources plants. Now the importance of forest resources. First important is it will be reduce the concept global warming. It means that the main greenhouse gases like CO, carbon monoxide, is used by forests for the process of photosynthesis, and it will be sinks for CO2 and thereby reducing the greenhouse effect due to CO2. So that the forest resource is very important to us for the reduction of global warming. After that, the second important use of forest resource is conservation of soil. Actually, this is the importance of forest. They prevent soil erosion by binding the soil particles tightly in their roots. They also reduce the velocity of wind and rain, which are the chief agents causing erosion. so that the forest research will be very useful to reduce the erosion of soil. And due to that forest or these trees, the velocity of wind and rain which will be increases, so that it is very important to us. Third important is improvement in fertility of soil. This is very important concept, because we are the people, most of them living in rural area, and our fathers and mothers will be work in farm, so that the fertility of soil is very important for the better production from our farm. So this fertility will be improved by means of this forest resource. The fertility of soil increases due to humus formed by the decay of forest litter, so that the improvement in fertility of soil, the forest resource, will be very important. After the concept of importance of forest resource, we will going to turn our next concept, deforestation. The meaning is, forests are exploited since early times for humans to meet human demands. The permanent destruction of forest is called as deforestation. Definition is very important as concern to our examination. The permanent destruction, the destruction word will be highlighted, because this word will be dropped in our examination and the sentence will be given for the MCQ. So that the permanent destruction of forest is called as deforestation. The picture will be show the well the meaning of deforestation. Now the question is arises that why this deforestation will be formed. That is the causes of deforestation. Mainly two causes. One is explosion of population. This is due to root cause of all the environmental problems. Vast area of the forest will be cleared by means of humans for his settlements and for the construction of his home. Second one is shifting cultivation. So these are the different types of causes of deforestation. Next one is effects of forestation, deforestation. The effects will be divided into two different types. One is soil erosion and the expansion of desert. These are the different types of effects we will going to observe when the deforestation will be take place. So today we will going to stop here. The remaining point we will going to discuss in our next lectures. But before going to stop lecture, you will well understand the concept of forest resource and the deforestation. You know that most of the effects and causes of deforestation, the only one solution is that you will able to do, means you will going to plant a tree. And definitely these effects will be going from our self. So today we will going to stop here. I request to everyone, please plant a tree. And thank you once again for watching all this video. If you have any query or questions, then you will definitely ask me. Once again, I would like to thanks everyone.